gentlemen.
You know, getting an all-star caliber player like Blake, pairing him with Drummond in a new arena down in the city, I think it's great for the franchise. Take a look
around me. I want to play for an organization that wants me to play there. Clearly, this was an organization that wanted me to play here, and this is where I want to be. I mean, this is a place that wants me, and that's the type of organization I want to play for. You know the
truth can be a weapon. Welcome to the Motor City, Blake Griffin. Ill intentions. New answer to the same
question. How many times will you learn the same lesson? We're talking about a guy who at 28 years old has already had at least 6 surgeries and hasn't been an all-star in 3 years.
He's not an all-star player anymore, so his value is definitely dropping, and it's dropping fast. 'Cause we're gonna be
legends. This is the downside of those kinds of contracts for these kinds of players. At the back end, they are not gonna look good. Ain't you scary? It's about to be legendary. Is he the eye-popping talent a franchise can build itself around? Or the kind of overpaid salary cap drain a franchise feels lucky it traded away? Is he as dominant as ever when he wants to be? Or a one-time prodigy robbed by injury?
Like, I still think he can be an all-star if he's healthy.
We made some great strides and we put down a good foundation, so I'm excited for this summer, getting to work with everybody.
The Pistons need to fill their new building. Griffin is a big name.
Blake Griffin reminded everybody that he is still Blake Griffin.
Drive, lays it up, lays it in!
Not only clearly will he be an all-star in the East, but he and Andre Drummond are going to be a dynamic interior duo to be reckoned with.
I can tell you that's one of the most entertaining Pistons basketball games that a lot of us have seen in recent years. What did it take for you guys to pull this thing off down the stretch?
We just kept fighting, man. We kept taking punches. You know, at halftime, I said this wasn't going to be a game where, you know, the person who punches the most wins is going to be the person who can take the most punches.
Yeah, this is excellent ball handling by a guy 6'10". Do you know who's leading the NBA three-point percentage?
Blake Griffin?
Absolutely.
It's unbelievable, man. I mean, these fans are so knowledgeable. You know, when the crowd's like this, it's a blast, man. We need our fans. It makes it that much easier for us.
He would finish with 50 points, which is a career high. But maybe even more importantly, it's the most points scored by a Piston in a dozen years. A reminder of how long this franchise has been lacking a star in his prime.
Blake is that centerpiece. If he can continue to be consistent playing this way, dominate inside, making great passes, leading his ball club.
We gotta lock in and finish games. Like, our lack of focus at the end of games has been awful. That's why we lose games like this.
When Blake Griffin is playing his best, he is a versatile Swiss knife of a basketball player.
Everybody here should get on their feet and give this guy a standing ovation, and they are. He is appreciated by what he has done. Here's a guy.
This is the Detroit mentality. He has that type of mentality. Plays hurt, does all the little plays.